Hey guys, it's Will. So everyone is saying that AI is a bubble, but here's the truth. The market's been cooling off, but rates are expected to drop. The government's most likely going to be opening back up, and the real world value of AI has been proven. So we're talking about technology that people are using every single day, and companies are powering it and expected to invest more in it. And behind the scenes, what's powering AI are the data centers. So we're going to be watching those today. I'm going to be breaking down the top three, starting with APLD. And by the way, we're currently here in Buenos Aires in Argentina, visiting some family, but we're still live every single day at market open. If you want to tune on in to those live sessions, it's not here on YouTube, it's somewhere else, but it's the second link below. We have a government shutdown offer special. It will be going away. It's the second link in the description below to tune on in. So let's take a look here. We do see some, a little bit of green, maybe potentially after hours, but for the most part, most of the markets were turning red on Friday. Now, here are our top data center plays. We're going to start off here with APLD. APLD stock is a company that we've been invested in for quite some time. We started covering it around $1 a share. So it was back in April when we started covering it. $3 a share. And we've seen it have some momentum from $3 into the summer, getting as high as about $16 a share. And then here into the fall, at least in the fall in California, where I'm from, but here it's spring here in Argentina. But we've seen it now surge through September, making this very consistent uptrend and making a run really up into about $40 a share just last Thursday. So with that move, after that $40 run, a very strong move, we have some positions on APLD we're up about 130% on. But here's the deal with the data center market. Most companies are at highs right now and then just correcting back down. But APLD, while they have corrected back down and just basically bounced at $30 a share, they could be continuing this overall uptrend. So we're kind of looking at this level saying, okay, what if this is just a pullback before the continuation for the company? Now, they could, if they don't hold that $30 to $35 range that they're currently in, then yeah, we would see a true break in pattern and probably get them pulling below that $30 range down to $25 or more. Maybe finding support around 25, but there's a reason that they've gone up to $40 and they are still holding their overall uptrend, which is something to consider. As you know, a lot of the markets pulled back, we are still seeing them not completely break pattern. In fact, this is very healthy, very good that we see the markets pull back. Now, there's three things we look at in a stock. So for APLD, very simply, again, data center market, this market's growing fast, AI is growing fast. They are building the data center, so they specialize in the construction of these data centers, and they have had some contracts totaling about $11 billion to $15 billion with some hyperscaler AI companies, for example, CoreWeave. And what they do is they go directly to the point of generation, so wind power, solar, hydroelectric, and they build data centers in cold places. So they've announced that they're building a 250 megawatt AI data center with CoreWeave in North Dakota. That's a 15-year term, $7 billion. So as you can see, the market's growing. The news looks pretty good. And then the partners, you see NVIDIA, Dell, and Intel, it would make sense they continue to grow. Now, when we look at the financials and what that's meant for them, you know, $7 billion here, $3 or $3 billion again, they have seen revenue increase as well. Quarter over quarter money coming in has increased up 84% year over year. And then their balance sheet, their assets have gone up to about $2.4 billion. So if they are currently valued at $10 billion, they have a $2.4 billion balance sheet. And their revenue here is on track to probably come in around $250 million. That doesn't look so good with their market cap. They look pretty overvalued. That's the reality of the financials. But the reason that we look at, for example, you could head over to NASDAQ and we could look at the institutional holdings or the insider activity, but really the institutional holdings. You could see that BlackRock is acquiring more. Vanguard has been staking a big position here, 14 million shares. Goldman Sachs and State Street have pretty good positions here. And so the reason is, why are they buying it if the financials don't look perfect? It looks like they're valued pretty high compared to what they have. It's got to be the deals. Again, $7 billion, $11 billion deals. If those hit the balance sheets, now this market cap of $9 billion looks very small. Looks like they should be a $50 billion company with something like that. Does that make sense? So that's kind of the reasoning for that. Now, when we look at their news, it looks fairly good. The financials still lagging behind. The chart, they recently pulled back from $40 down to about $30. So again, if they can hold that $30 to $35 range, kind of consistently pushing up, that's good for them. If they are not able to hold that $30 to $31 range, we are looking at shorter term, probably seeing some pullbacks. Now, I use AI all the time. And one of our favorite platforms here is right here, this future-based charting platform. We recently launched this in the last summer here. I can search any stock. I'll start with APLD and we'll get a little bit of analysis here. Now, the next company that we're wanting to look at too, we're going to be looking at companies that are not just building data centers, but having the service that they're providing the market. Some companies, they build data centers and then they're wanting to do it so they can just mine their own Bitcoin or what have you. Maybe that's somewhat valuable because Bitcoin, not that it's inherently valuable, but it's valuable because it's something that people prefer as an asset as opposed to relying on the US government or things that could be printed like dollar bills. They want that that security of having an asset that's not manipulated like that. And so, you know, data centers in that instance could be valuable. But when it comes to the types of companies I'm focusing on with data centers, we're focusing on the ones that are helping big tech be able to scale, because AI or even small tech be able to scale with AI. Because AI is growing very fast and there's a huge demand for more computing power. And so data centers allow that to happen. Now, if you look at the projections here with APLD, this is according to Grock. And again, we're on our platform here. This machine, that's what we call it, is something I use quite daily. You can see daily, there's a 2% sell down potential on APLD. However, our machine is indicating that we are going to see after this sell down, potentially, according to Grock, paired with the SEC data, the insider trading data, you know, all of the indicators, the real-time data that we give it, we're getting this analysis here that's putting it at around 8% growth over the next 3 months, and then holding into that $40 range here over the next 6 months. So it looks pretty bullish according to the AIs and according to all the analysis that has gone into it over the next few months. But again, on the next day, kind of looking bearish. Now, that's number one. Number two for data centers. This is a company that I've been focusing on just a little bit recently, and they might still be a little bit overvalued. We're kind of looking for a recovery, which we did start to see that 10% recovery. We just started trading them last week, and they kind of broke pattern recently, but we're following them because they're in the data center space as well. And there's a lot of data center companies. There's a company called Hive, there's iREN, there you could look at TSSI, that's one we've been following quite often. There's a lot to follow. You could look at Wolf Stock, you know, there's a lot. AMD is even in the data center space. But what I'm talking about, and you could screenshot the list, you have the list right here, right in front of you. If you know, this is what I reference this list a lot that we've built. But I will say that BITF is a stock that is fairly low key, and they kind of started out as data centers for, or not even data centers, just like Bitcoin mining. And now they're kind of positioning for power and potentially leveraging their setup for data centers. And they have a few set up. They have this one in Panther Creek. You can see 60 megawatts future capacity, 80 megawatts. Like these are pretty big. This is another spot there. And then you got Washington, 18 megawatts, watts 60, 30, 22, 18, 17. They go a little bit smaller there, but they have a bunch of these data centers. So they're a company that is positioning. They're saying, hey, AI is going to get really big. We're kind of ready for it. We're building these data centers, and they've been preparing themselves. Now, when we look at the financials, you can see their revenue has been increasing as well. Still negative net income in June, but their revenue is up 87% year over year. Their balance sheet looks very disciplined. Look at the quarterly growth. You see their assets going up and up and up and up. Still down here year over year, just a little bit, about 38%. And liabilities have risen just a tad, but they're now up to $827 million in assets. You see that up. So the last year, we're seeing some momentum build there on BITF. And I think it's probably a result of increased spending on the AI infrastructure from companies. And this company is one that's enabling that. So they're at a $3.9 billion market cap, but with about $1 billion almost in assets, and bringing in, on track to bring in at least around $300 million, I think that they are potentially going to be a long-term growth play. So I like them. You know, we do see a pullback recently, and we're getting into the charts now outside of the financials. You can see that pullback down to this level. There was a previous resistance here, pretty strong, kind of in this range around $4, $5 a share. We traded them last week when they pulled down to $5, and we sold around $6. And so we're looking for that level, $5 a share, near support level. We'd be looking for them to potentially validate it or even continue from where they're at on Monday. With the next target, bullish target would be up into that $6 range, about a 24% range margin for profit from $5. And that's where they were touching there on Friday, right around $5, and then jumped up to $5.30. So looking for that growth of about 10 to 15%, potential up to $6. Now, we'll see overall direction. Definitely could see some big growth if governments open up, if you know, the what's the other thing that's got to happen, dollar sees some strength potentially, or maybe even the opposite, we actually see a little bit of a asset inflation more. That's something that's been happening, not just that the government shut down, but that we've had rate cuts, and when rate cuts happen, you got money printing up, people spending more money. And so that's what's going on with the main market, the macros. So we're kind of looking, we'll see how they hold around $5. I like the company, I'm gonna watch them closely. Now, the next company is gonna be TSSI. Now, TSSI has been in a little bit of a downtrend as of recently, but overall, they've seen some growth. Now, they've been kind of pulling back down to this last resistance and support around $15 a share. But I'm looking for them to potentially recover into $17. The three things that we look at, right? The market, obviously data centers, but when we look at TSSI, see their market here, they're at a $440 million market cap, fairly small, and they're bringing in, on track to bring in about $300 million this year. So they're already bringing in almost as much as their market cap. Their balance sheet doesn't look crazy. They still have some positive equity. But overall, where they're seeing growth is their revenue. In fact, they almost had $100 million in March 2025, that reporting. So if you look at that, if they were to do that, their market cap's way undervalued, and they could be, you know, $1 billion to a $3 billion company. Now, what is it that they do? They provide data center services to help companies build structure into their data centers, whether that's configuration, whether it's the technical side, the IT infrastructure, maybe it's even the racking systems. They do that, and they work with rack integration. You could see data center moves. So if they're a company is moving their data center, AI and cybersecurity, structured cabling, all that good stuff here in the data center market. And they've seen a lot of revenue, so that's why we're watching them. Now, when it comes to the projections that we have here. I'd like to pull it up as well. Let's pull up Grock. We'll do Grock here. Just keep it congruent. Cool. And TSSI also, when we look at the institutional holdings, that's been kind of interesting. Let's take a look at the institutional holdings. Go over to the view, and we got insider, or let's see, institutional holdings. Here we are. Here we are. Institutional holdings indicate BlackRock has been buying. Okay, seeing some shares held. Vanguard, and we do see Renaissance Technologies there as well. Increased position 79. They still don't have a lot of institutional ownership like other companies. I think APLD was around 40-something%. They're still around 25%, but we've seen more increased positions than decreased, which indicates bullish momentum for the company. Now, outside of that, they are at a support level right around $15. That's a level that I would like for them to potentially bounce. And it would make sense if you are looking for data center companies that are not getting a lot of attention. It would make sense. There's not a lot of hype around the stock, anything like that, that I've seen around the company, that they're kind of a lower attention play, which potentially, like I mentioned, low institutional investment right now could mean that they see more influx. It doesn't necessarily mean that, but in the data center market and just looking at their financials, they have some of the characteristics that would indicate that they would see institutional attracting value here right now. And the volatility is real. We've seen big spikes. Last time they were at this level, they spiked about 25%, and then they fell just as fast from $21 back down to this level right there. You can see that big sell down. So, you know, we're watching them closely, and I'm most likely going to be opening up some long-term positions much heavier with TSSI. And I do like to, hold all the companies that we end up, if we do trade them shorter term, usually, if probably 9 times out of 10, we're also holding long-term positions. And then when we get back to the Mercatus projections, fairly similar. We're looking at negative about 2.5%. According to Grock and all the real-time data that we were able to essentially give to Grock. So we give it, again, all of the real-time data that we can provide to the models. And in this case, it's Grock. But over the next week, looking bullish. Over the next 6 months, looking bullish as well. So again, seeing some corrections and then looking pretty bullish over the next year. As far as projections, most likely that's a fundamental play there and why that's looking that way for TSSI. So there's a ton of honorable mentions. Companies that are integrating into AI fast and building data centers that are growing quickly. Now, if you want to stay up to date with them, definitely make sure to subscribe. But also, if you want to learn how to invest in data center companies, quantum computing, space tech, the top companies that are in defense right now and in AI, then I would encourage you to join us in our daily live trading sessions. We are there Monday through Friday. It's not here on YouTube. You can get a link in your email each morning. It gets sent over to you in your email, and you tune on in. You get to see us invest live Monday through Friday in our daily live sessions. And also on top of that, you can get a free t-shirt. Surround yourself with about 28 millionaires inside of StockMate. That's how many we've tracked. Get some targets for the next week. Get learning materials to learn technical and fundamental analysis and how we do all of our analysis inside of StockMate. So if that's you and you're looking to get to the next level, you can join in on our daily live trading sessions as soon as Monday in our next market open session. And I would love to see you there. Again, it's the second link in the description to join StockMate. If I earned your thumbs up, hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.